All you do is text the word Cater Pro to the number 44222 and booyah, you're entered. There'll be instructions, okay? It'll text you back. If you did it right, it'll text you back and say, congratulations, blah, 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 click here and confirm. And that's it, okay? Now, if you missed Sunday, we did our monthly live show. We used to do them weekly, now we do them monthly. But Sunday, every first Sunday of the month, we do a live show with pro vendors and vendors from all over the world. We had a ton of vendors there, and I think it was downloaded a little over 4,000 times in the first 48 hours once we got it uploaded. You can go listen. It's free. Okay, you can go to learnhotdogs.com. It's right at the top, somewhere near the top two articles. You'll see it. And you can listen to that show. It's got a lot of valuable information. If you're serious about this business, you're constantly adding. You're constantly adding to your knowledge base. You're constantly getting better. That's why I do this. It's so that I can help people. We all pull our knowledge and experiences together, and we put it out there so that everybody can learn. I call it getting your learn on. So, vendor of the week. Okay, vendor of the week. Two kids and a cart. And there is a link probably going to be down below. Okay, I think Heather's going to put it down below. There is a link for you to go down there and go visit that page. Go look at that. Two kids and a cart. Congratulations to y'all for being the vendor of the week. We pick these at random. And so Heather goes and sends her spies out and finds, you know, a vendor of the week. And we surprise them and y'all. So maybe you'll be next week. The Facebook page is kind of a long link, but if you click, there's a short link down below, or just a link. You can just click it and go. Now, there's photos showing the progress of his build. He built his own cart, and you'll get to see that process. He's got photos there on the page. Check that out. Here's a question from vendor. Now, while we're going through this, there's if you have questions, simply post them down below. And hopefully I'll be able to see them. I don't see them here. I may not be able to see them. So if you post your questions, I don't answer them. I may answer them tomorrow for you. Because I can't see the questions here. For whatever reason, it's not showing me them today. And it's a new feature they just added where I could actually see the questions as they came in. And it's not working. So I'm not going to worry about that. And we'll just skip that the questions part. You can still add your questions. Heather will grab them up and give them to me. Okay? It may be tomorrow, though. So, first question, though, is, hey, everyone. I recently bought a used cart to get started in food vending. Currently, I'm getting all my ducks in a row with paperwork, and it's going well. Looking for advice about the cart. There is a lot of carbon in the firebox. And the pans were horrendous. Pans have been restored. How do you all clean the burners? Maybe they are toast. Any ideas? Typically, burners are not toast. Okay? If they have cast iron burners, which is what we put in our carts, those will last eons. They'll last longer than you'll be vending. Okay? Unless something catastrophic happens, like a saltwater flood and the cart gets flooded, it could corrode those little portholes. Now, replacing stuff like the pitot tube, which is the little tube that sticks in the burner, but a cast iron burner should last for years and years, 10, 20 years, okay? But they still need cleaned every now and then. Take a wire brush and scrub it down. You can even take WD-40, spray it, then scrub it down. It gets the rust off. But mine rust all the time. I don't care, okay? You can spray them with that grill paint. That'll last you about two outings, and then it's gone. I don't care what they say about that stuff lasting. It doesn't last. But if you want to keep them pretty, for whatever reason, you can. Now, when they stop working correctly, that's when you need to clean them out. Sometimes you can go to a gas station, air hose, and blow them out, okay? Sometimes you have to slide back the tube that feeds the gas in. Because usually that's not attached, So you can wiggle it around and blow any rust particles or anything that's gotten into the burner. Most burners are circle or oval. Now, if it's a stainless steel burner, those rust even worse as far as they deteriorate faster. Because the heat, cool, heat, cool, heat, cool, they will deteriorate faster. They don't last as long. You've probably, if you've had an outside backyard grill, you know this already. Those little stainless steel burners, they're the cheapest stainless steel they can get, and that's what they do. Y'all have heard me do the thing about the stainless steel magnet thing. If a magnet sticks to it, it ain't real stainless steel. It's like my refrigerator says it's stainless steel, but magnets stick to it. Magnets don't stick to stainless steel. But basically, stainless steel is an alloy of multiple metals, and they put a lot of the cheaper metals in and then a little stainless steel, and so you end up with this, it's magnetic, which means that it will, you know, a magnet will adhere to it. So, if your cart says, oh, it's stainless steel and a magnet sticks, it ain't quality stainless steel. It ain't 304 grade, which is a top grade if you don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, question from, I hope that helps you on your burners. Probably don't need to replace them. Try to clean them first. If that doesn't work, replace them. It's not hard to replace. Question from Facebook, I think. Has anyone converted an electric steam table to gas? I need to know just how much air I need. Will I need to remove the entire bottom or just an oversized hole for the burner? Are side vents necessary? Great question. This is a trial and error thing because it depends on the size, the depth. It depends on your altitude. It has a lot of things, but it's pretty easy. It's really not such a critical thing. You want the right amount of airflow, but there's a big curve. You know, it doesn't have to be precise. That's why grills come with the little slider so you can adjust the airflow. Same deal. If you're getting, like the last question we got, a lot of soot and carbon buildup, that means they were not getting enough oxygen, which meant unburnt gas changes over, turns into this carbon mess on your cart and on your pans. That black stuff, that soot on the bottom of the pans, that is from either your fire's too high or not enough oxygen. So realistically, I would just bore some holes in the steel or the wood around your table. Just a few holes, try it. Bore a couple more, try it. And the crazy part is, on a windy day, you may have to tape up some or block them off with duct tape or something. So it's not a big deal. Side vents doesn't really matter. It's all venting. So it doesn't matter if they're on the front or on the side. You don't have to have them on all three. You can have them just on the front, just on the sides. Probably a good idea is just to put them on the front where you can see your flame easy. That's what I would do. And yes, there's a lot of people that have converted from electric to gas. Electric is slower to heat up and blah, blah, blah. It's great for indoors, but it sucks for venting on the road to me. You don't heat up as quick. So are side vents necessary? No. Question from the I Love Street Food vending page here on Facebook. This, Ben, here is the question of the day. Do you put condiments on the bun first or do you put condiments on top? Which is the best way? It sounds kind of like a dumb question, but you would not believe how many people want it on the bottom and how many want it on the top. Some of my customers ask for it on the bottom, but normally I put it on the top because it looks better. What do you do? I put condiments on the top. I do. Now, if I'm using cheese slices, like I'm doing something and I'm using cheese slices, I put that on the bottom. Hot dog on top. Melts in. If I'm putting something that isn't quite hot enough, like I just opened a new jar of jalapenos and they're quite not hot enough, I may, you know, where I like them a little room temperature or, you know, hotter, I'll put those on the bottom, just a few of those, put the hot dog on top, heats up quickly, nicely, right? But if I'm delivering, like let's say the courthouse used to call me and go, hey, Ben, we need 11 lunches. And my wife would run them down to them, or my daughter would run them, one of my daughters would run them down to them. Well, I'd bag those up. Well, the problem with the condiments on the top, when you wrap the dog in the aluminum, because I wasn't using the styrofoam boats, because that's more money. So I had to wrap them, you know, I put them in a sleeve and twist it, the aluminum sleeve. Well, when you do that and the condiments are on top, it gets all gooey and nasty, right? And they take it out and it's a big mess. If you put them on the bottom, doesn't do that. So you can put your drier condiments on top, wetter condiments on the bottom when you're delivering, or whatever the customer requests if they're at your cart. If they're not at my cart, I do it. I put them on the bottom if I'm having to deliver it or they're sending somebody to pick it up. I don't want it to be a nasty mess when they get it. And that helps prevent that. It does look better though, Michael. It does look better on top. It's prettier, okay? So presentation-wise, always on top. If I'm just serving off my cart, they're going on top unless the customer asks otherwise. Here's something from this page right here where we are. Oh, and by the way, there's some links up here you may want to check out after the show. This is, Ben, I want to take a moment to thank you. I was laid off from a job back in 2008 making $20 an hour and went 5 months without a job. I'm sorry to hear that. That sucks. I then was hired by a company making less than half of what the money I made worked back up to a decent, hold on. Company making less than half of what that I worked my way back up to a decent amount of money that in September of this year I got laid off again. I started a job in November, starting all over again, making less than half again. It was at this point I decided to find something I could do. I stumbled across your videos. They motivated me to pursue the hot dog cart business. I have applied for my LLC due here around the 7th. I missed out on the used cart for $900. There's more used carts, don't worry. So I found a used 2016 and I'm in the process of leasing. I've spent a lot of money so far and don't even have my cart yet. Yes, LLCs are expensive. I explained that recently in a Facebook video right down below, right down there. There is an actual video down there where I explain that, how you don't have to start with an LLC. Yeah, don't. It doesn't even help you to start with an LLC. You can start as a meat company. A sole proprietorship. If you're listening, you haven't started yet, start with a sole proprietorship. As long as you convert it by December 31st of that year, it's as if you had the LLC the whole time. Saves you time, saves you money, saves you headache getting started. I missed out. Let's see. I'm so scared and excited at the same time. I can relate. But I will succeed. Put that in caps. Thanks to the motivational videos of yours, I wanted to join your Vendors United group, but that will have to wait as funds are very tight. I understand completely. Don't worry about it. Vendors United is $27 a month. It is going up. So if you want to lock in that rate, you may want to get that. $27 a month is less than a dollar a day. That's cheap, cheap, cheap. But if money's tight, don't do it. Don't do it yet. Wait till the cart can pay for it. Sorry to be so long-winded, but again, I just want to thank you again, wishing you and your family all the best, safest holidays. God bless. Thank you very much. That's it. Unless there's something I missed, and for whatever reason, I can't get... I'll tell you what. Bear with me just a second. I'm going to go get my phone and see if there's any notes, any questions that I need to answer real quick, because I didn't bring my phone in here with me because it rings. Hold on just a second. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Let me change this back over. Hopefully you see me now again. I'm here again. Let me give you something cool and pretty. Look at this. I love playing with this stuff. I'm having so much fun. Alright, look at that. Sexy? I'm talking sexy. Now, here's a question. John asks, Ben, any advice for someone looking to start a cart in Southern California, in and around Orange County? Yeah, it's the same advice I'd give you if you were in Wake County, North Carolina, or Knox County, Tennessee. Do your due diligence. There's nothing that it's all the same. It applies everywhere. It's the same rules, same everything. You don't have to. There's no extra anything. Just follow the same rules. If you don't know where to begin, go to learnhotdogs.com and click on the free training. It'll walk you step by step everything you need to do, John. Steve says, does the Stand King have ceiling lights? Yes. Shows it in the video. It's listed in the description too, on the Stand King page. But you can add more. I just had a guy send me, he replaced all his lights with solar. He put a solar panel up there that he got at Harbor Freight. I have an article on how to do that on the Learn Hot Dogs blog. He put that solar light up there. He did that, and our solar panel on top, a small one. It was less than $150 and on Black Friday. And then he put in these low wattage LED strip lighting, and it lit up the place like 4th of July kind of thing. So yeah. Question on, Michael asks, found a spot. How do I get the owner to let me set up there? Sell myself to him? Actually, I have the actual wording for that. And if you, it's on learnhotdogs.com, free training. I think it's the second video or third video. I tell you exactly what to say. It's on the location video, maybe the fourth video, but it tells you exactly what I say. So that it makes them, and keep this in mind, feel like you're doing them a favor, which you actually are, even if they don't know that yet. You're helping their business. You're creating this nostalgic feel. You're making a more pleasurable experience for their customers. So absolutely, absolutely do watch that, and it'll tell you my exact wording. You can change that to fit you, okay? And fit your style or fit your personality. But you want to kind of, you don't want to go, hey, can I sit up in front of your place? I really like to get a place right here. And this, y'all seem busy. I can make a lot of money here. You don't want to pitch it like that. That ain't even a pitch. That's just dumb. What you want to do is say something like this. I'm going to just give you a tip. Say something like, hey, my name's Ben. I have Hillbilly Catering and Hot Dogs. And we're going to be in your area next week. Thought you'd like us to stop by. We'll serve your customers and stuff. You don't have to pay for anything. The customers pay for it. And we'll have fun. We're licensed, bonded, insured. How would you like that? I can be here Thursday, maybe Friday, but not sure yet. Oh, what does it cost us? Not a thing. Doesn't cost us you a thing. And we'll set up for a couple of hours. We'll leave the place like we found it. It'll be clean. And booyah. Here's a picture of our cart. Oh, check out our Facebook page. You know, that's the kind of stuff you can do. So that's it. I think that's it. And I hope y'all have a fantastic weekend. I'm sorry I've been out a lot this week. I have been busy. I told y'all on the Sunday show, I have never been this busy this late in the year. Usually it's slower and, you know, I got time to fish. You know, I can go crappie fishing and stuff. And this year, nope. I ain't even been fishing. I've been fishing once since September, which sucks. So, anyway, if you have questions, you need help or anything, always check out learnhotdogs.com. Always post a question here. I promise we'll answer as many as we can. And we haven't left anybody out, I don't think, ever. So, hope y'all have a fantastic day. Remember, if you don't know anything about this or you want to learn more, and you want to get better, learnhotdogs.com/do it. It's been on the bottom of your screen for the last 20 minutes. Check that out. And before I go, I'm going to put up this real quick. Win a cart right here. You can win a cart. Why would you not want to try? Okay. It doesn't cost you a dime, a text message. Okay. And there's ways I send you a text back that tells you the ways that you can increase your odds. Right now, there's one person who's like got multiple odds of winning because he's shared it and done all that stuff. It entices you to share it, is the bottom line. I love you. Hope you have a fantastic weekend. I'll talk to you.